A very good day to all of you. In the previous class, you learned about some options of the format Meno, like default formatting, and about character, and about the paragraph options. Let us now revise what you have learned in the previous class. Can you tell how we can remove the text boundaries? In order to remove the text boundaries, you need to click on the text boundaries sub-menu of the view menu. Can you say why we use default formatting? With the use of default formatting, you can remove any formatting done like font size, font color, bold, italic, background, etc. done on your text or paragraph and bring it to its original form. Can you tell why we use the paragraph sub-menu of the format menu? If you want to make settings for your paragraph, for instance, how much space to leave before writing your text in the paragraph, and also how much space you want to leave after writing, you will use the paragraph sub-menu. This will also help you in making the first word of your paragraph bold and in capital, as also in creating a border on left, right, up or bottom of the paragraph. Now, all of you switch on your computer and using the new method taught to you, open your writer files. Have you all opened the writer file or no? In today's class, we will learn about the remaining options of the format Meno. What you will learn today is about the page sub-menu and its usage, and also the usage of bullets and numbering. Next, type out the line being shown to you and copy paste it 10 times. Make sure that each copy is pasted in a new line. If you have any problems, then watch the video and learn from it. In this video, we are going to learn and practice the use of copy paste. So, once your line has been typed out, first select this line by any of the methods that has been taught to you, and then you can use the shortcut command Ctrl plus C to copy this line. Let us see in the video. This has been selected, and then once we use Ctrl plus C, it gets copied, but there is no change that appears on the writer page. Now, to paste it in a new line, you need to click near this line and then press enter so that you go to a new line. Now, let's use the shortcut command Ctrl plus V to paste a copy of this line. Again, press enter and then Ctrl plus V to get another copy. Like this, we can get the number of copies that we require. Let us also use the edit and from edit, pick the paste option. Once again, go to the edit in the menu bar, select paste option and keep doing this till you have 10 copies of the line. So this is how you can copy and paste 10 copies of the same line. One more time. We go to edit and then select that and then select the paste option. So now you have 10 copies of the same line. Have you all copy pasted the line 10 times? If not, then you must watch the video again and learn. Let us now learn about bullets and numbering. Can you tell why we use bullets and numbering? If you want to prepare a list and want to put different types of symbols in front of these lines, then you can use bullets. Using the bullets option, you can put bullets in front of each line. If you want to put numbers in front of the lines, then you can use numbering. Watch the video to learn about the usage of bullets and numbering. Watch this video to learn more about bullets and numbering. So if you want to get bullets or put numbering in front of your lines, position the cursor in front of the first line, then take the pointer to the menu bar as is being shown in the video to you and click on the format option. And from the options available, click on bullets and numbering. Then in the box which opens, click on the bullet tab or the bullet option. Now there are number of types of bullets available. You can choose the one which you like and click on that as is being shown in the video and then say OK. Click on OK. So you will notice that the bullet appears in front of the first line. If you want to remove it, you can just go to the bullets option in the bullet toolbar and click on it and it gets removed. Now if you want to insert a different type of bullet, go to format, go to bullets and numbering and select the different type, click on OK and you see that the bullet reappears with the selection that you have made. Click on the second line, beginning of the second line, go to format and let's see how we can insert numbering now. So again click on bullets and numbering. And in the box, select the numbering types option. And you will see a number of options available. Choose the one that you like and click on that and then click on OK. And you will see the number appears in front of the line. If you want to remove that, you can take your pointer to the numbering option in the bullets and numbering toolbar and click on it and it will go away. If you want now to bring the cursor to the beginning of the third line, go again into bullets and numbering option. Click on outline this time. And you see that there are a variety of outlines available. You can select the one which you like. Click on that. Click on OK. And you see that the outline appears or the number for outline appears in front of the third line. Go to the fourth line beginning. Take the cursor to format. Bullets and numbering option has been selected. Now click on graphics to see what graphics are available. You can scroll up and down and there are a number of graphics options available. Click on the one which you like. And then click on OK and you will see that a graphic symbol appears in front of the fourth line which you had selected. Now, if you want to remove this, you can do a backspace or you can do undo. But if you want the same graphic to appear on the next line, just go to the end of the fourth line and click enter and you will see the same graphic appearing. If you click at the end of the third line and press enter, the outline next number 2 appears. When you go to the second line at the end and press enter, the numbering 2 appears. Again, if you want to remove this, you can use backspace or do an undo. Or you can even go to the bullets and numbering toolbar and click there to remove it. So in the first line, we have also shown you in the video how you can press enter at the end of the line and get a similar bullet for the next line also. So this is how you can use bullets and numbering. Let us now learn about the page submenu of the format menu. Using the page submenu, you can know about the page, the background of the page, header and footer. Using the page submenu, you can manage the border, columns, etc. The very first option of the page submenu is that of page. The picture in front of you shows the options of the page submenu. We will now discuss about paper format and we'll learn about the types of paper format. Let us now watch the video and learn about paper format. With the help of this video, let us learn about using the page format. To use the page format, we have to bring our pointer to the format option in the menu bar and then select the page option. A box opens. You need to click on the page option or the page tab in this and you see paper format. Below the paper format, there are three options: format, width and height. If you press on the down arrow in the format box, you can see number of styles of the paper format. So you can click on the one which you want, like A4 size is the normal size that we use. So let's click on letter. Now if we want to increase the width of our page, we can click on the up arrow in the width option and this way increase the width. We can also, if we want, increase the height by clicking on the up arrow in the height option, and then you need to press on OK. Once you do that, you will notice that in your paper, in the page, writer page, both things have got applied. So the height has increased and the width has increased. This is how you can use page format. Next, you will learn about orientation. Can you tell why we use the orientation option? With the help of the orientation, you can change the property of your page. That is, you can change its height or width. Orientation is of two types: portrait and landscape. Currently, the page you are working upon is in portrait orientation. You can see that the height of your page is more than the width. If we change this to landscape orientation, you will note that the width becomes more than the height of the page. Let us now watch the video and learn about using orientation. Let us watch this video and learn the use of orientation. So, to change the orientation of your page, you need to take your pointer to the format option of the menu bar and then click on page. A box opens and you have to click on the page option or the page tab, and within that you see below the paper format there are two orientations. The default is portrait, in which the height is larger than the width. If you click on landscape and then click on OK, you will notice that the page orientation has changed. It has become more wider and less in height. If you want to bring it back, go back to format option, select page and then select the portrait and click on OK, and it becomes normal. Now you will use the background option. Can you tell what happens with background option? Using page background, you can change the background or the color of the page. We can also put an image as the background on our page. Let us now watch the video and learn how we can change the background of the page. This video will help us change the background of a writer page. To change the background, bring the pointer to the format option of the menu bar and left click on that, and then from the options which appear, select page. A box opens and you have to choose the background tab or the background option. In this, you can see that it shows color and various colors are available to choose from. If you click on the down arrow, you can see that the other background can be graphics. Right now we are choosing color, and then from amongst the colors, choose the color which we like and click on OK. Once you click on OK, the color gets applied on your writer page and you can see that the background comes in that color. Now if you want to change and want to bring a graphic or a picture behind your page as background, go to format, select page, and then from this drop down, click on graphic. Now click on browse so that it will show you various options where your pictures could be, desktop, downloads, or in pictures. So in this case, our pictures are here, and we click on the picture that we like and then we say open, click on open, and then here the picture will come and you can see the preview of that picture. Click on OK and that gets applied on the background of your page. This is how you can use the background option. Come, let us learn about using the header and footer option of the page submenu. Can you tell why we use the header and footer? As you know, we use the header when we need to show a title or a book's name on each page. We can use the footer to show page numbers on each page. We can use this option to also increase or decrease the margin of the box size of our header and footer. You should also learn how to use the margin. Now, let us watch the video and learn how we can put the header and footer. This video will teach us how we can insert the header and footer on our writer page. Let us first learn about the header. So to insert the header, take your pointer to the menu bar as is being shown in the video and click on the format option, and then select the page option, and then here select the header option or the header tab. You will notice that none of the options are highlighted. Once you click on header on, a tick mark will appear as is being shown in the video, and then all the options get highlighted. So the first option is for the margin, setting the margins. If you do not want to choose the options right now, if you just click on header on and then you say OK, click on OK, you will notice that the header gets inserted on our writer page. Now let's see how we can set the margins and change the specifications of the header. For this, take your pointer once again to the format option of the menu bar, click on that, select the page option, click on that, and then from look at the left margin, bring the pointer to the up arrow, and if you click on the up arrow, the left margin increases, which means that the header moves away from the left text boundary. Once you apply this and say OK, you will see that the header moves away from the left text boundary, and you can see here it has moved away from the left text boundary. Now Let's go back to format. Select the page option again. As is being shown in the video, select the page and we can change the spacing also. If we increase the spacing by the up arrow, the space between the text or the top boundary, text boundary and the header increases. As is being shown in the video, this space has increased. Now, let's go and see what else we can do with the header. We can change the size of the header. So, go to format, go to page, and then come to the height option. If you click on the up arrow, you will see that the height is increasing. You click on OK and you see that the height of the header has increased. Now let's type your name or any title that you want to give in the header. Like in this video, we are putting a title of Computer Shiksha. So this is how you can insert a header and change with the page submenu of the format menu. Now, let's also watch this video and learn about the footer. So, take your pointer to format, click on the page option, and now from the box which opens, click on the footer option or the footer tab. Again, you see that the options are not selected. So you have to click here on the footer on option. You see a tick mark and the options get selected. Now, if you don't want to change any of the options and just click on OK, your footer gets applied on the writer page. This video will show you that the footer has been inserted at the bottom of the writer page. It is here. Now let's see what changes we can make. Go back to format, select the page option, and now in the header we had changed the left margin. Let's see what happens if we change the right margin. So let's click on the up arrow in the right margin box or the right margin option and increase it. So with this, what is happening is, when you apply it by saying, clicking on OK, you will see that the footer has moved towards the left side from the right text boundary. So you can see this in the video, it is being shown to you. The footer has moved away from the right text boundary and gone towards the left. Now once again, bring your pointer to format, select page, and let's increase the height of the footer. Or let's first look at spacing. So when we click on the up arrow in spacing, the footer is moving below the bottom text boundary. So the space is increasing between the bottom text boundary and the footer. This is being shown in the video also. Now let's see how we can increase the height. Go back to format, select the page option, and now look at height. The option for height, click on the up arrow and you can increase the height of the footer. If you click on OK, you will see that the footer size, the height has increased. Now if you want to insert, say, a page number, you need to go to the insert menu of the menu bar, go to fields and click on page number option and you will see page number appears in the footer. So this is how you can insert the header and footer on your writer page and make changes. The next option is about the border of the page submenu. Can you tell what happens with the page border? Using the border option, you can put a border on all four sides of the page. you need to select the type of border that you want to put on the sides of the page. You can also choose to have the border on the left side of the page only. You can also change the line width of the border. Let us now learn with the help of the video more about the usage of the border. In this video, we will learn how we can set page borders and make changes to it. So to set the page borders, we first have to bring a pointer to the format option of the menu bar, select the page option, and from the box which opens, click on the borders option or the borders tab, and you see a number of options here: line arrangement, line style, spacing to contents, and shadow style. So you can see in the line arrangement, there is a default option where there is no border, which is the first option. Second option is for set all four borders on all four sides. The next option, as is being shown in the video, when we bring the pointer there, it says set left and right border only. The next is set top and borders, top and bottom borders. And last option is to set the left border only. So whichever we like, for instance, if we like to set all four borders, we will click here. We will be getting border on all four sides of the page. We can also select the line style that we want. Bring your pointer here on the scroll button and you can move up and down to select the line type that you want, line style. And you can also change the color of the line with which the border is drawn on your writer page. Click on the down arrow and scroll up or down to see the different colors which are available. And you can select the color which you like. Now if you press OK, you will see that a page border has been applied to your page. You can scroll up and down your page and see that the border has come. Now if you want to make changes to this border, let us see what else we can do. So take your pointer to the format option in the menu bar. Click on that. Click on page, as is being shown in the video, and in the box we have to click on the borders option or the borders tab. Now let's see spacing to contents. So with this we can change the space that is there between the border and the text. If the synchronize is on, which means there is a tick mark in the synchronize, if you change any of the spacing to contents, left, right, top or bottom, all of it gets applied to all the four options. As you can see, if you want to change only one of them, then you have to remove the synchronize by clicking there. And then if you want to change the left spacing, you can come here and click on the up arrow to increase. Once you press on OK, you will see that the text or the left text boundary has moved away from the border of the page. Again, go to format, select page, and you can now change the top by increasing the top with the top arrow, up arrow. Like this, you can change the spacing to contents by and click OK. You will see that the top of the text boundary has moved away from the page border, top page border. Again, go to format, select page, and you can now decrease or bring it back to normal by either individually doing it, or you can click on synchronize so that all the options are synchronized and all of them get reduced. Now if you click on OK, you will notice that your text has gone back to as it was normal. Again, let's see what if other effects we can do to the page border. So let's go once again, take the pointer to format option. Click on that. Click on the page option. And now look below, you can see shadow styles. So there are four shadow styles shown here, five shadow styles. Cast shadow on top or right in this option. Cast shadow to the bottom left. Cast shadow to top left. So if you select cast shadow to top right, click here and then these options also get highlighted. So you can increase the distance by clicking on the up arrow, which means that the distance of the shadow from the border is increasing, or you can decrease by clicking on the down arrow. You can also change the color of the shadow by clicking here on the down arrow and scrolling up and down. You can select the color which you like for the shadow and then click on OK, as is being shown in the video, and you will see that the shadow has got applied as per your desire on the borders. We will be ending this class here. All of you should save your writer file and properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you learned about options of the format menu like bullets and numbering. You also learned about using the sub-menus of the page. Thank you.